الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا واعتدلوا اقبلوا على الله بقلوب خاشعة وصلوا صلاة مودع إن شاء الله درجة سجدة عند سكند ركعة إن شاء الله الله أكبر الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين هو الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وجعل منها زوجها ليسكن إليها فلما تغشاها حملت حملا خفيفا فمرت به فلما أثقلت دعوا الله ربهما لئن آتيتنا صالحا لنكونن من الشاكرين فلما آتاهما صالحا جعلا له شركاء جعل له شركاء فيما آتاهما فتعالى الله عما يشركون أيشركون ما لا يخلق شيئا وهم يخلقون ولا يستطيعون لهم نصرا ولا أنفسهم ينصرون وإن تدعوهم إلى الهدى لا يتبعوكم سواء عليهم أدعوتموهم أم أنتم صامتون إن الذين تدعون من دون الله عباد أمثالكم فادعوهم فليستجيبوا لكم إن كنتم صادقين ألهم أرجل يمشون بها أم لهم أيدي يبطشون بها أم لهم أعين يبصرون بها أم لهم آذان يسمعون بها قل ادعوا شركاءكم ثم كيدون فلا تنظرون إن ولي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين والذين تدعون من دونه لا يستطيعون نصركم ولا أنفسهم ينصرون وإن تدعوهم إلى الهدى لا يسمعوا وتراهم ينظرون إليك وهم لا يبصرون خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ فاستعذ بالله إنه سميع عليم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده حمدا طاهرا طيبا بارك فيك. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. إن الذين اتقوا إذا مسهم طائف من الشيطان تذكروا فإذا هم مبصرون، وإخوانهم يمدونهم في الغي ثم لا يقصرون، وإذا لم تأتهم بآية قالوا لولا اجتبيتها، قل إنما أتبع ما يوحى إلي من ربي، هذا بصائر من ربكم وهدى ورحمة لقوم يؤمنون. وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون. واذكر ربك في نفسك تضرعا وخيفة ودون الجهر من القول بالغدو والآصال، ولا تكن من الغافلين. إن الذين عند ربك لا يستكبرون عن عبادته ويسبحونه وله يسجدون. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يسألونك عن الأنفال، قل الأنفال لله والرسول، فاتقوا الله وأصلحوا ذات بينكم، وأطيعوا الله ورسوله إن كنتم مؤمنين. إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم، وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. أولئك هم المؤمنون حقا، لهم درجات عند ربهم ومغفرة ورزق كريم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى. سبحان ربي الأعلى. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى. سبحان ربي الأعلى. سبحان ربي. آمين. الله أكبر. والنبي ورحمة الله عباد الله الصالحين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن عبده ورسوله. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير الضالين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. طيبا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي الأعلى. الله أكبر. بسم الله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير الضالين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. طاهرا طيبا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سبحان ربي، سبحان ربي. الله أكبر. الصلاة والطيبة السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. الصالحين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن رسول الله. اللهم صل وسلم تعالى بارك على وعلى آله وقائمنا في العالم قيم الصلاة من بريث. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الحمد لله. As you know that's Dr. Yusuf al-Qaradawi, Imam al-Asr, the leader of the scholars of this century, he passed away today. So his janazah tomorrow in Doha. So inshallah we have short program. Inshallah now me and the Sheikh Uthman inshallah for maybe 10-15 minutes max inshallah. Please stay with us here to know what is number one about ilm, what is the benefits of ilm, number two what is the position of Dr. Yusuf al-Qaradawi. Why the people they talk about Yusuf al-Qaradawi like that? Yes, he's qualified for that. So inshallah maybe before sunnah is much better. Before sunnah is okay. خلاص ان شاء الله فرصه لنا ان شاء الله. تفضل شيخ اسمع. If you want one microphone can use the second one ان شاء الله. ان شاء الله باذن الله we'll start with a few verses from سوره الاحزاب يعني recited by شيخ عثمان من المؤمنين الرجال.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. ولما رأى المؤمنون الأحزاب قالوا هذا ما وعدنا الله ورسوله وصدق الله ورسوله وما زادهم إلا إيمانا وتسليما. من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه، فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر، وما بدلوا تبديلا. ليجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم ويعذب المنافقين إن شاء أو يتوب عليهم، إن الله كان غفورا رحيما. صدق الله العظيم.
الحمد لله، الذي قال في كتابه من المؤمنين رجال. الله says in the Quran in Surah Al-Ahzab من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه. Maybe the real man, he can be, inshallah, steadfast and so for a while. Then he changed his mind. But if someone he stayed, he steadfast for one century, 100 years, no change, no compromise, until he meet with Allah, and he got the position of ilm, of fiqh, of wasatiyah, of fikr. So inshallah, we'll listen to a few words from Sheikh Uthman about Dr. Yusuf al-Qaradawi. May Allah bless him in Jannah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحان الله. يعني one like me, يعني it's very humble to talk about one biggest scholar like الشيخ القرضاوي. If الشيخ حمدي والله not force me, I'm not do it, because we have to learn from يعني the one who got PhD from الشيخ القرضاوي. I listen to one example for Sheikh Dr. Muhammad al-Saghir. He says, I am the youngest student for him. He is Ustaz Doctor, يعني from Jamiat al-Azhar. He says, I am youngest student for him. His student, mashallah, became ulama and shiukh, Sheikh al-Qaradawi. About his, subhanAllah, his birth date, he born in Qarya, in al-Gharbiya, تسمى صفت تراب, in ربيع الثاني, second, 1355, ربيع الأول, second, إحنا في ربيع الأول برضو صح؟
لا, إحنا في صفر.
ربيع الأول, second, in 1345 هجري, يعني almost 100 years. يعني the birth date in September, he born in September 1926, almost 97 years. As the scholars, they say, he memorized the whole entire Quran before he reached 10. He memorized the whole entire Quran and the tajweed and everything about the Quran. He started giving speech and khutbah in early time. يعني after 12 he gave a khutbah in his قرية, and then in المحلة الكبرى, a big city, they asked him to come to do khutbah there. The people come from everywhere to listen to him until they make extend for the masjid, يعني three طابق, يعني three floor, يعني beside the original one. And after a while they call him to go Cairo, to give khutbah there. The people come to listen to him from everywhere. And until, subhanAllah, يعني with this يعني ما شاء الله love of the people for him. سبحان الله they put him in jail يعني like three or four times until he decided to go to Qatar and he established a lot of Islamic institute. One of them كلية الشريعة في قطر 1977 until 1990 he is the عميد الكلية and he ما شاء الله he put a lot of Muslim and he established also اتحاد العالمي لعلماء المسلمين a big مؤسسة. All of them they are علماء, they have to sit and decide any problem happen for this ummah right away and they have to give fatwa and give their opinion about what happened. الشيخ القرضاوي يعني you can يعني summarize his life in one ayah from the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام, إن إبراهيم كان أمة. إبراهيم عليه السلام كان أمة. والله أعلم ولا أزكيه على الله. This is my opinion. الشيخ القرضاوي you can give this description for him. القرضاوي كان أمة. And my يعني what to say, my humble proof for this, you never found يعني any part from the ummah need support, you will found الشيخ القرضاوي support this part from the ummah. Name it. He support the brother in Palestine, support brother in Gaza, support brother in Kashmir, support brother in Syria, support brother in everywhere. And they told him يعني false تهمة. They say you are from علماء السلاطين, you are يعني make something for the ruler to make you closer to them. He told him, if I am like this, they not push me to go out from my country. He lived all his life, most of his life, out of his country. He born in Egypt. But he lived the whole life in Qatar. He told them, if I am like this, with little mudahana, with little compromise, with I'll be in the head of everyone. In Egypt, but I never make mudahana with anyone. I still say the truth in everywhere. Either they like it or they don't like it. But he, subhanAllah, I just, inshallah, give the microphone to Sheikh Hamdi. Sheikh Muhammad Sagir, Dr. Muhammad Sagir, Ustaz Dr. They asked him, what you can say about him? He says, استكتبنا الشيخ القرضاوي. تلاميذه, he asked his student and his dakatra and his علماء to write anything about him. Some of them they write al-Qaradawi faqihan. Some of them they write al-Qaradawi sha'iran. Some of them they write al-Qaradawi murabbiyan. Some of them they write, يعني subhanAllah, so many. يعني five مجلدات about al-Qaradawi. But he said, I'm talking about him, I write about him al-Qaradawi insanan. He says, subhanAllah al-Azim, he write it down, how many books? 200. Wallahi, I hear some, واحد اسمه جمال نصار, he took about one book, Al-Halal Al-Haram. He write it, this book in 1980. They say they write, they repeat to print this book, how many times? 40 times. 40 مرة يكتبوه. Not only this, the all Arab and non-Arabic, the Islamic country, they translated to their language. And the Sheikh Ali Tantawi, he said, any Muslim family have to have this book. And he teaches his students this book, Al-Halal Al-Haram. He write Fiqh al-Zakah in century 20. The scholars, they say, the book of the century, the whole century, Fiqh al-Zakah. What he write about Zakah? اعتبروه كتاب القرن. And he wrote also another book, يعني one of them, فقه الجهاد, they considered this the book of 2021. It's the book of the whole century. Because subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him, subhanAllah al-Azim, open mind, and he read about all the scholar, and he live in this century, and he يعني have vision about يعني what they learn from the old scholar and what he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened for his mind to learn. Right now, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this day the best day for him. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this night the best night ever for him. May Allah bless him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him with the Nabiyeen and the Siddiqeen and the Shuhada al-Salihin. Wa hasanu alayka rafiqa. Wa jazakum Allah khairan.
جزاك الله كل خير. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We are not going to keep you longer, but إن شاء الله بإذن الله صلاة الجنازة صلاة الغائب will be Friday إن شاء الله. Friday after صلاة الجمعة. إن شاء الله we'll try to hold صلاة الجنازة after both the first جمعة and the second جمعة إن شاء الله to let everyone at least share this خير إن شاء الله for the علماء. When we talk about Dr. Al-Qaradawi, I want to highlight just one point. One point about al-ilm, If you lived in this dunya, if someone asks you after 60, 70 years, what you have done in this dunya, somebody will say, wallahi, I bought a house, I have kids, I have so. But when we come to ilm, what Allah says about ilm, what Allah talk about ilm, mention about ilm, Allah says in Surah Al-Mujadala, يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ العلم. Allah says, when Allah taught His Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, He told him what is the best dua. He told him, He taught him, say, وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. Dr. Al-Qaradawi, he lost his father when he was 2 years old. His father, Abdullah Al-Qaradawi, passed away when Dr. Yusuf Al-Qaradawi was 2 years old. And his uncle starting to take care of him. So his uncle decided to keep him beside him. No education needed. Stay with me and work with me and so. And who can spend for you? And he used to escape from his uncle to go to the Al-Azhar Institute for elementary. So subhanallah, then he got the first place and he kept himself in the first spot, first place in all education. He memorized the Quran, as the Sheikh mentioned, memorized the Quran early time. Before 10, he finished the Quran. Imagine, completed the Quran. Then the Quran affected his life. Alhamdulillah, Allah blessed me to meet with him, to introduce him in some lectures. Alhamdulillah, Dr. Al-Qaradawi, he got sick in 1985 or 90, I don't remember the date exact. And he 1 year in Ramadan spent it in the hospital in Europe. And they asked him, what you missed in this Ramadan? He said, I missed to lead the people with Taraweeh because I used to finish the Quran, leading the people during Taraweeh to recite the entire Quran in Ramadan. He memorized the Quran and he used to lead the Qiyam, which is honor to serve the Quran, the book of Allah. And he did that. So Dr. Al-Qaradawi, Allah gave him ilm. And many people, they have ilm, but maybe some people, they are scholars in fiqh. Some people, they are scholars in tafsir, in Quran, in ijtihad, in fikr, how to guide the others to the moderate way of Islam, not extremely right or left. If you can find some people in some area of ilm, but Dr. Al-Qaradawi, he was on the top in all of that. And subhanallah, Dr. Muhammad Shanqiti, today he said, subhanallah, there is no one can even compete with Dr. Al-Qaradawi everywhere in the world to say he's competing with him. If we lost him, we lost one of the pillars of the scholars in this century. We do not know who can fill this gap. And also see the vision. When you have vision, you will find the person based on what he's planning to do based on his vision. So what he done? He can stay in office and so, or brand the book or so. No, he's looking for the ummah, for the future of the ummah. Sheikh Uthman, he mentioned that he got, they put him in the jail, not only in the time after 1954, but even before that,
1949, in the time of the king in Egypt. They put him, he was about 23 years old, they put him in the jail. Then he got also in the jail three times after that. So, but even in the jail, he knew, he drew his way. And he printed one of the poetry, 278 line, 270. I memorized that long time ago when I was young. And even when he came here to give the lecture here, I gave a part. When I introduced him, I gave a part from that. This part, even he said, "Khalas, in the jail, I know what I am going to do now." What? He said, whatever torture that happened, I never change my mind. He said, "ضع في يدي القيد." Sorry for giving that in Arabic. I can't give it in English, يعني perfectly. ضع في يدي القيد ألهب أضلعي بالسوط ضع عنقي على السكين لن تستطيع حصار فكري ساعة أو نزع إيماني ونور يقيني فالنور في قلبي وقلبي في يدي ربي وربي ناصري ومعيني سأعيش معتصما بحبل عقيدتي وأموت مبتسما ليحيا ديني. So he knows what is the way that's the way to please Allah, and if your goal to please Allah alone, that you'll find that in every aspect, even if any single word you say, you will find it there. When he established for the future of the Ummah, established Ittihad Ulama al-Muslimin, International Union of the Scholar, Ittihad of Muslimin. Subhanallah, and he said, somebody asked him, "Okay, you are close to the Hukam, the leaders in Qatar or so." He said, "No, I am not good enough to please the rulers." Why? Because I have to say the truth. And he said the scholars in International Union, they said, "What is the title? What is the title for our union?" He said, "Put this verse: الَّذِينَ يُبَلِّغُونَ رِسَالَاتِ اللَّهِ وَيَخْشَوْنَ وَلَا يَخْشَوْنَ أَحَدًا إِلَّا اللَّهِ." Put this verse. Those the scholars, the real scholars who deliver the message of Allah, and they have to deliver the message completely. They do not fear any but Allah alone. They fear Allah. So, subhanAllah, and he lived. He supported the Muslims in Palestine, in Burma, in Kashmir, in Iraq, in Syria, in everywhere. Even also, he said, subhanAllah, his teacher in Al-Azhar, his teacher in Al-Azhar, Sheikh Muhammad Al-Ghazali, alayhi rahmatullah. Sheikh Muhammad Al-Ghazali, he is older than him about 8 years, 8 years older. He was his teacher. Sheikh Muhammad Al-Ghazali, he said, he told him, he met with him after, when he recognized him, he said, "I was your teacher, but now you are my teacher. Imagine, Sheikh Uthman, he mentioned that the book of the century, last century, that's Fiqh al-Zakah, two big volumes. That's anyway, that's the PhD message by him. He got PhD in Zakah based on this book, two volumes. And this year, 2022, when he is 97 years old almost, then he printed the book, the last book for him, Fiqh al-Salah. 750 pages this year. And he printed over 200 books in all aspects of ilm. So when we talk about ilm, don't waste your life. Don't waste your life. Learn something to benefit. When the Prophet ﷺ says in the hadith, قال إذا مات ابن آدم انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث صدقة جارية أو علم ينتفع به أو ولد صالح يدعو له. If the son of Adam passed away, his deeds will stop except from three sources. Number one, continuous charity. Number two, علم. علم. Imagine when we read his ilm. His ilm everywhere. Do you know Dr. Al-Qaradawi in 1979, which is about 43 years ago, he led the janazah for Abu al-A'la al-Mawdudi in India, the scholar of India and Pakistan. This is the scholar Abu al-A'la al-Mawdudi went there and he read the janaza for Abu al-A'la al-Mawdudi there 43 years ago and they prayed behind him. Maybe Allahu A'lam how many 100,000 they prayed janaza behind him. Dr. al-Qaradawi, he came here and Alhamdulillah, Allah honored us. He came to this masjid. He gave a lecture here in this spot and he gave the khutbah here and he came to Maya conference 1998 and 1999. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless him in Jannah. Just few words, we cannot يعني, cover that, but we remind you, number one, tomorrow inshallah they have in Ar-Rahman Masjid in Garden Grove, Dr. Muzammil Siddiqui, Sheikh Ibrahim, Sheikh Mustafa, some others there inshallah, also to talk about him, and they will pray Salat al-Ghaib on him after Isha in Garden Grove. For us here, inshallah, Friday, bi-idhnillah, Friday after the first and second Jum'ah, we'll have inshallah Salat al-Ghaib for him. Some people they say, why Salat al-Ghaib for him? What not Salat al-Ghaib for my father, my mother, passed away and so? Why especially Dr. al-Qaradawi? Maybe because the Imams in the Masjid here, they are from Egypt and he's from Egypt? No. We do that, that is the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad. For the famous scholars, for the figures of Islam, for the people serving Islam, yes, it is recommended for every Muslim to share this, to feel what we missed. We missed a lot. We missed a lot. The scholars cried. Why? They know. The hadith of Prophet Muhammad, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبِضُ الْعِلْمَ انْتِزَاعًا وَإِنَّمَا يَقْبِضُهُ بِقَبْضِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Allah doesn't take the ilm like that. But Allah takes the ilm when the scholar died. If the scholar died and no more scholars like that, then if any fatwa and we do not get the right answer, then what? Who can give us the fatwa? Some people, they are not qualified for the fatwa. So they will lead ignorant people, they will lead ummah, then they will give wrong fatwa, they will misguide them, and also they are misguided. So اتخذ الناس رؤوسا جهالا فأفتوا بغير علم فضلوا وأضلوا. So we ask Allah تبارك وتعالى to raise for this century inshallah بإذن الله this century another scholars to lead the ummah, to guide the ummah to the right path, to be able to say the truth even if the oppressors liked or not liked. For sure the oppressors they dislike those kind of people. For sure, they dislike them. They dislike to see someone to say, don't do. As Allah تبارك وتعالى says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهِ أَخَذَتْهُ الْعِزَّةُ بِالْإِثْمِ فَحَسْبُهُ جَهَنَّمْ وَلَبِئْسَ الْمِهَادِ. Some people, when you say, don't do, that's wrong, they will get upset. But it is wrong. Thank Allah that someone, he told you that's wrong. Thank Allah that you got nasiha. Pure nasiha for someone. But this nasiha should be based on ilm, not based on the hawa, that's a desire or so. No, based on haqq, based on truth. So نسأل الله تبارك وتعالى to bless him in Jannah, to bless all of the scholars. And if you hear someone, they said, but I dislike al-Qaradawi, I dislike his fatwa. That's normal. Do you think all people, they love Allah? Many people, they do not know Allah. Do you know that all people, they love the Prophet Muhammad Sallam? No. Even some Muslims, they have something wrong. So, do you think that all people, they will love you? No. So, do you think all people, they will love Dr. Qaradawi? No. Some people, they hate haqq, as Allah mentioned in the Quran. So, and those people, they do not make any difference. Now he's between him and Allah. What he done, what he left, that's recorded for him. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, we can end this with dua inshallah from Sheikh Osman.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Allahumma ighfir lahu warham. Allahumma afihi wa afu an. Allahumma akrim nuzulah. اللهم وسع مدخله اللهم أبدله دارا خيرا من داره وأهلا خيرا من أهله وعشيرة خيرا من عشيرته. اللهم إن كان محسنا فزد في إحسانه وإن كان مسيئا فتجاوز اللهم برحمتك عن سيئاته. اللهم اغفر له ما قدم وما تأخر، اللهم احشره مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا، اللهم اجعل ما تركه من علم في ميزان حسناته يا رب العالمين، اللهم جازه بالإحسان إحسانا، اللهم جازه بالإحسان إحسانا، اللهم جازه بالإحسان إحسانا، اللهم ارفع درجته، اللهم ارفع درجته، اللهم ارفع درجته، اللهم لا تفتنا بعده ولا تحرمنا أجره، واغفر اللهم لنا وله ولسائر موتى المسلمين أجمعين، اللهم اغفر لحينا ومن لشاهدنا وغائبنا، لصغيرنا وكبيرنا، لذكرنا وأنثانا، اللهم من أحييته منا فأحيه على الإيمان، ومن توفيته منا فتوفه على الإسلام، اللهم اجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله، سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، آمين.
جزاك الله بخير، قم الله منا ومنكم.